This is Sangjiaji National Park, the real-life inspiration for the scenery in Avatar.
Incredible.
It's one of China's most breathtaking landscapes, and today we're going to explore some of the highlights here.
I think I'm seeing the pinnacle a little bit more up close than I had originally anticipated now.
They're the stairs of Frankenstein.
We bought our ticket, went through the security check. There was absolutely almost no people, just 20 or 30 people, while it's like the middle of high season.
They make you scan your finger here to make sure you can't give your ticket to someone else, yeah, I think that is, because the tickets are quite expensive.
Yeah, and it's for like 3 or 4 days.
It's currently like 7:15 a.m.
Yeah, the park just opened like 15, 20 minutes ago, so we'll be one of the first in.
We're hoping to avoid the crowds just a little bit.
We're now going to take the shuttle bus.
Tight squeeze in between these buses.
So we made it to the first point in the park. Wait, let me read the name. Yuanjiaji. We're now going to walk for 25 minutes into the park. That's the advantage when you come on the northern side. You're already at the top part, at the most beautiful part, the scenic part.
We are following a big Chinese tour group.
Apparently we had to take another bus, another 5-minute bus ride to get to where we were going. It's not always that easy on the map. Guy that the guest says where you're staying made this map himself. But it's like not to scale, so it's not always like very easy to comprehend.
Seems our friends, the Chinese, found the first scenic spot. We're not nearly alone here, but wow.
I just cannot believe this landscape.
It's
this
crazy.
Must be, oh, you can see cars down there.
Yeah, you can see the cars down there. That's crazy.
So small.
When we were coming up, we were apparently driving next to these huge pinnacles. I thought we were just going through like a mountain range or something, but
it's
it was already the
really
pinnacles.
Incredible to see these pinnacles.
Also, like all the plants
that
are growing on top of them, all
There's
the bushes and
plants
trees.
Plants and bushes and
that
everything.
Makes it really cool.
It's still a little bit foggy though. I think it will clear up once it gets a bit warmer.
You're gonna have to chuck him overboard at some point. Wow. Wow, 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 wow.
This is the main event of the day. These are the famous Avatar Mountains. I think the one in front of us is the Hallelujah Mountain. After Avatar named it Hallelujah Mountain, they changed the name here as well. Probably for commercial reasons, but...
Oh my god, this is so cool.
This is so amazing.
And the crazy thing is, this little viewing deck right here, we have it to ourselves.
Yeah.
I mean, there's no one here.
Well, there's now two people behind us, but when we arrived here, there's nobody here. It's crazy. Over there and over there, there's like a few hundred tourists.
Chinese everywhere.
Nobody.
I'm going to tell you what the Lonely Planet says for the park.
Don't drop your phone.
I will do it. Yeah, I'm not going to drop my phone. That would not be such a good plan right now. I'm going to do it in my best. What's he called again? Not James Attenborough. David Attenborough impression. Rising from the subtropical and temperate forests of northwest Hunan, that's the province we're in, Zhangjiajie has a concentration of quartzite sandstone formations found nowhere else in the world. There are some 243 peaks and more than 3,000 karst pinnacles and spires dominating the scenery in this UNESCO-protected park.
So what do you think?
I love it. I really, really love it. It's beautiful here. It's one of the craziest landscapes I've ever, ever seen. Sunscreen. Okay, I have to admit, it's not sunscreen. It's like an actual tear. I don't know. I've never shed a tear over a landscape, but this is just so beautiful. Incredible. I didn't think this would be here in China, I mean, what a country. First he wanted to take a picture with me, and then he was like, I need to take a picture something with his nose, and then he wanted me to get out of the shot, I think. I'm not really sure, but they're so adorable, these older Chinese people. They always want their picture taken with you.
Now we're moving to the next part of the park, the other two parks. This was Zhangjiajie, now we're moving on to Zhuangjiajie. If you think it sounds the same.
It sounds exactly the same to me.
So we have to walk back a bit and then take the bus all the way to the other side of the park.
Buses are right over there. The queue is pretty long, but I do have to say the Chinese are pretty well organized. I mean,
yeah, they're so well organized. It's like buses riding every 5 to 10 minutes, I think. So maybe we'll have to wait for like 10-15 minutes, but it's okay. Have a little rest, see, plan our route a bit more.
And pretty much everywhere you have to go in the park, you can get close to it by bus, which really helps, because otherwise we'd lose a lot of time walking in parks that aren't really necessarily that scenic. There are a lot of places where you can get some food here. The pathways are super well maintained, super easy to go about. Really, so far, I'm impressed with the Chinese organization.
You can even be carried down the mountain in a chair.
There are several people doing it, actually.
This is really crazy. I've never seen this. I saw these people with the chairs and I was like, it looks like something you like pull or carry or something. It was always like one guy and I was wondering. Now you see it just carried with two people. What the hell? Okay. We are now here in the Zhangjiajie area. So we're going to walk around here and here, which are some of the more beautiful areas with some very beautiful scenic points. Apparently here in the end, there's a really nice point our guide told us, so we're going to check it out.
Bye, good luck. So far it has been a little bit surreal being in this landscape, because when you're very high up on the pinnacles, up on the plateau, it looks a little bit like you're looking at a painting or something. Beautiful painting, but you don't feel like you're really a part of the landscape because you're not in it, you're just looking at it.
Now that we are descending, it's really impressive to see these pinnacles, and they just go up so high. When you look from above, okay, you can see they're pretty high, but now you can just see them towering above us. It's really, really cool.
Hello!
Hello! That is next level. That's advanced stuff on these stairs. This section is a lot of up and down, up and down, up and down. And you come closer and closer to the pinnacles. Really nice.
It seems we have an obstacle course here. It's time for the duck walk, I think. Quack, 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 quack.
Quack your head against the rock. This board here is pretty narrow. My shoulders just fit through. This is really narrow. My shoulders don't fit through this. I'm gonna have to take the bag off, because that's not gonna fit.
We've now reached the top of this pinnacle where the Wulong village is situated.
Over there is this cute little pagoda on the craziest pinnacle lookout point, and that is where you're heading to next. What was it we said again about these very well-made paths? I'm seeing the pinnacle a little bit more up close than I had originally anticipated now.
They're the stairs of Frankenstein.
Yeah, it's crazy. We have to climb.
They even built a McDonald's here. You can have a McDonald's here. I mean, what the hell? In the middle of the park, who eats at McDonald's here?
Yeah, that's crazy.
I mean, it's crazy. Like, you come here and then this beautiful park, and then you go and eat at McDonald's. No? Kim?
thing that man is trying to push me into buying an ice cream.
One. Yes, one.
It was already the perfect day, but now it's the perfect day with like a sugar / chocolate rush. Finally, proper ice cream. Every ice cream I've tasted so far here in Asia was like, eh. But this is not proper, I mean.
I mean, I still can't believe you're eating ice cream here in the park. I mean, from McDonald's. I mean, what kind of tourist are you?
Oh my god, I'm so tired.
Yeah, it was a pretty tough day. We left at 7 o'clock. No, yeah, we left around 7 o'clock this morning.
It's six now. Six.
So it was an 11-hour day, but really cool.
What a day.
So amazing. Some of the most, well, not some of the most, for me it was actually the most beautiful scene we've ever seen. Yeah. So if you're going to China and hesitating whether you should do this or something else,
come here. Yeah.
Come here, do this.
Because we almost skipped this. I was like telling you that I didn't want to come here because it is quite expensive.
I mean, it's not super expensive, but like for an entrance fee, it's already quite a lot.
It does get you access to the park for 3 or 4 days.
3 or 4 days, yes.
Even if you just want to go one day, you'll be paying for basically 3 or 4 days. Because it's not just what we did today. What we did it today is like really the highlight.
Yeah.
I mean, it's why it's pretty crowded as well. But there is a lot of other cool places that you can go inside the park. We hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like and hit the subscribe button. Don't hit it too hard, don't hurt it.
We're going to travel more to China. We're going to Shanghai, to Guilin, Yangshuo. Maybe we're looking into some other places because we love China so much. I think we're going to stay a bit longer than we expected. So.
Oh yeah, it's incredible. And please, tune in for the next one. And please, leave me alone now because I have to go to sleep. Bye.